أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم. In this series, inshallah, I would like to discuss various hadiths from the chapter of Dua from Sahih al-Bukhari, which is considered to be the most authentic book of hadith that we have in our ummah. Our religion is based on combination of both Quran and hadith. So, our religion is incomplete without hadiths. At first, I would like to discuss the importance of hadiths, and then I would like to have a small discussion about Imam Bukhari and his famous book Sahih al-Bukhari. According to Surah An-Nisa, ayat 65, for any disputed matter, if a person have iman in his heart, he must make Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the judge over that matter. And he must not feel any difficulty or discomfort in submitting to the judgment or solution as declared by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Without hadith, how can we make him sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the judge over those disputed affairs? If we consider ayat 59 of the same surah An-Nisa, we must obey Allah and his messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam unconditionally. After that, if there is any disagreement over something, even that disagreement came from the authority above us, which goes against Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is the Quran and the Sunnah. If we truly have iman over Allah and the Day of Judgment, we have to follow the Quran and the Sunnah for the ultimate solution. In Surah Ali Imran, ayat 31, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that if we love Allah, we should follow His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love us and forgive our sins. In Surah Al-Hashr, ayat 7, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that if the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us to do anything, we must do it. And whatever he has declared to be forbidden or haram, they are haram, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself made it haram for us, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has delegated this right to our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam by this ayat. One should not reject hadith arguing that he is not sure whether they are rightly preserved or not. It is a common sense argument that since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires us to follow the sunnah, he must have preserved it in overall sense, in its entirety. How can we expect to follow the sunnah in this age and time and till the end of time? The answer is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has preserved in overall the hadiths, the messages, and the seerah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam for us and for the later upcoming generations to follow them. Now, let's have a brief discussion about Imam Bukhari. His actual name was Muhammad, and his father's name was Ismail. Imam Bukhari's father died when he was a young kid. His father used to travel the lands and he was also interested in hadiths. His father even sat in the circle of the famous Imam Malik. There is a story that Imam Bukhari was blind and with the dua of his mother, his sight was recovered. He is called Bukhari as he was born in the city of Bukhara. He was very intelligent with great memory. When he was 16 years old, his mother took him for Hajj and he was amazed by getting into touch of the scholars over there and requested his mother to return back to Bukhara and he stayed to Medina to study Islam. He traveled a lot to learn Islam and returned back to Bukhara after 45 to 50 years. At the age of 19 years, he wrote a 9-volume book regarding the narrators of the hadiths. He traveled to Baghdad, where he met Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, who praised him that he haven't met anyone in the entire Khorasan as bright as Muhammad ibn Ismail, that is Imam Bukhari. The scholars of hadiths almost unanimously consider Sahih al-Bukhari to be the most authentic and reputable among all the books of hadiths. This is because he only chose narrators of the most reliable characters. He verified that each person in the chain of narrators have actually met the person from whom they are narrating the hadiths. He only compiled the most authentic of all hadiths and sent the draft to the greatest ulama of that time, and any hadith that was found to be slightly objectionable, he striked out those hadiths from this book. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. Thanks.